Robert, thanks for joining us today. I've really been looking forward to this conversation because if you look at the industry right now, it's really a time of incredible change. Our customers need more and more computing capability, and they really need the type of technology and compute capability that we're doing in partnership with Dell EMC to provide better and better solutions.
No, thank you. Thanks for the invite, Mark. And I think you're absolutely right. What we're seeing in the customer base is they're all trying to go through their digital transformation. Mm-hmm. And compute has fueled the digital transformation in the industry. And right now, as they go on the journey of this transformation with new workloads, machine learning, edge compute, all of those new areas of compute that are driving new resources, new business models, new service disruptions are demanding more and more compute. And it's great to be a partnership with AMD to help try and solve those kind of problems. I remember when AMD, you know, called up and was, you know, re-emerging with a new architecture with the EPYC in the future. And we spent a lot of time together. And, you know, I spend a lot of time with customers, end users, HPC, across the world. And, you know, AMD did an incredible job of listening to our feedback, which was a direct reflection from all our customers, to add the features, capabilities, cores, I/O, memory, all of those things that then allowed us to go do unique platforms and innovations at the system level that previously, you know, we weren't able to do.
And, you know, to me, that's what I'm really proud of. As I look back at that partnership, I look at the PowerEdge scalability with a two-socket solution that can really handle really demanding high-performance compute workloads, a virtual desktop, but also really leverage what we were very focused on in AMD, and that is to provide a wide I/O opportunity, 128 lanes of connectivity coming in, 8 channels of memory. You fully exploited that on both your high-performance two-socket systems and a tailored one-socket system where you really needed to take advantage of, for instance, a lot of memory or NVMe capability that you put around that.
Yeah, no, they've been great platforms in the market so far. And, you know, on the two-socket, we're able to create a very rich, compelling two-socket that can handle anything from VDI to accelerators to big-end memory, lots of cores, lots of bandwidth. And then on the one-socket, you know, it's more tailored and optimized for an emerging world around, you know, having more flexibility. You know, there's a number of advantages on the one-socket world that we've been predicting. And, you know, it comes down to having enough cores, enough memory channels, enough I/O lanes. And I think, you know, in other areas that we've collaborated on really well is around security. From our standpoint, you know, we're able to design in system-wide security around our systems management, around our iDRAC, how we have an immutable hardware root of trust. So at time zero, we know that every piece of firmware on the box is ours, and it's secure and signed and hashed and updated for the lifecycle of the product. And so we're able to start with that foundation that then lets, you know, the innovations on your side come to play.
You bet. And as you know, we're committed to security as job one in everything we do. It's sort of foundational for our product development. And, you know, I think a couple aspects. One, it's been a year that really shined a bright light on security. There was exploits out there. I think our architecture with Zen has proven quite robust. Mm-hmm. And in addition, enabling encryption with secure memory encryption, mm-hmm. or also even in a virtualized environment with secure encrypted virtualization. So we're really pleased with those type of capabilities to be able to offer, and obviously more coming in our roadmap.
Really interested on your view of, you know, how AMD is going to address, you know, the future of the slowing of Moore's Law from a technology and what AMD is doing.
Well, to me, it's as our role as a CTO, I mean, this is, I think, one of the most important responsibilities we have. Our customers are banking on us, yep. that we do not slow down in delivering a Moore's Law pace, a doubling every 18 to 24 months of capability, even when the semiconductor technology nodes are in fact slowing down and not delivering the kind of frequency that they used to. And so for us, it's really twofold, Robert. One, as you know, we're unrelenting on our CPU roadmap. Mm-hmm. So Zen 1 shipping today, right on track with Zen 2 later this year, and Zen 3 completing, and our Zen 4 in high-level design. So we have leapfrogging design teams that will never let there be a gap in bringing more and more CPU performance at each generation. And you know, beyond that, as you and I know, it's more than just the CPU. It's about a balanced computer.
Right.
So we will scale our memory capability, our I/O capability. We invested in a chiplet approach that gives us more modularity to be able to give you more options as we go forward.
And I think the innovations that you're putting in and enabling this next generation compute to stay ahead of where customers need to be, whether it, you know, your chiplet approach that gives you more flexibility to continuing to push the lane count and the memory count that allows us to bring in heterogeneous computer domain-specific architectures, mm-hmm. Specifically on some of these new emerging workloads in the machine learning and AI space where, to be honest, you know, we don't know what the compute needs are going to be and what the math is going to be. I mean, the math that we're doing today is different than the math we did, you know, 20, 30 years ago. I like to think about it as we're moving from an era where we used compute to create data to now we're moving to an era where compute is being used to consume data and at a much different pace than it was in the past. And you know, and the math on it is different because we're really bringing in an analog world, and the math on analog is different than the math on databases 30 years ago.
Robert, I see so much change going on with algorithms and software applications. Data analytics is just taking off. We're seeing machine learning and both training and inference that our customers need to be able to run on their server systems. What are the ramifications that you're seeing on your Dell EMC designs going forward?
Yeah, so, you know, what's driving us in that space is, you know, to your point of customers entering the new era of machine learning, AI, and data analytics, and being able to offer them platforms that are flexible enough to accommodate all these changing workloads. And in partnership with AMD, given the lane count and the memory size, we're able to offer platforms that can be future-proofed for the unknown computational needs of the future.
Robert, I really appreciate what we've been able to do together with the industry to bring disruption, the launch we've had with EPYC and PowerEdge systems, the seamless transition that we'll enable later this year with second generation EPYC, and the ongoing work that we're doing with our teams to anticipate where workloads are going in the future.
Yeah, no, it's been a great collaboration to date, Mark, and I want to thank you for that. And looking forward, you know, the collaborations that we have going where we see where the market of compute needs to go to advance the state of the art in and around, you know, memory-centric, domain-specific architecture, optimized, edge, disaggregated, kinetic resources in the future. These are all exciting areas that you know, we're collaborating on and look forward to bring to market sometime in the future, you know, between our two companies through collaboration.
There will be no shortage of innovation and never a dull moment between our two teams. Thank you so much for joining us here today.
Thank you, Mark. Appreciate it.